mid-season glory. Same Hawk story. But you've got to give this guy a hand. He led his side on a bumpy ride. Tonight, we'll see if he's the best in the land. Sydney.
Wizard's wizard, and he's always a cheeky little bugger, and that's why we love him. He's just fantastic, and he can pop up and kick six goals. Next week, he might take Mark of the Year. He's very unpredictable, but you can count on one thing, he's going to have a dip each week.
The Wiz, Jeff Farmer, booted six to fire Melbourne. And Darryl White chipped in with five as Brisbane took top spot on the ladder as new coach Liam Matthews spoiled Tim Watson's coaching debut at St Kilda. The reigning premier started unconvincingly. The Bulldogs, with Hudson on target, making up for a preliminary final mauling by Adelaide.
Hutto is a guy who, just finishes off so well, and I suppose that's the major point of his game.
Hawthorn's talented youngsters helped account for Collingwood, despite the efforts of Nathan Buckley.
Yeah, Jared showed exactly what we hoped when we recruited him, and to his credit, he produced in a big game.
Adelaide Crows versus Lions versus St. Collingwood versus Hawthorn. Collingwood, N. Buckley, one vote. Hawthorn, S. Crawford, two votes. Hawthorn, T. Crowed, three votes. Fremantle versus West Coast Eagles. West Coast, M. Braun.
Win over Brisbane.
I like to walk out on the ground thinking I'm better than the next player or the player that I'm playing on. And that's what I've pretty much brought out of myself over the last couple of weeks.
Tim Watson enjoyed his first coaching success as St Kilda wrapped up its match against Melbourne by half-time. Stewie Lowe, the focal point. And victory for Adelaide. Pittman starring in a four-point win over Hawthorn.
Right. Adelaide, M. Stevens, one vote. Hawthorn, S. Crawford, two votes. Adelaide, D. Pittman, three votes. West Coast.
Three-point winners over Brisbane. Murphy and Brown in the midfield set up Carlton's win over the Bulldogs, while Scotty Cummings kicked seven as the Eagles kept their 1999 record intact with a six-goal win over Collingwood at Victoria Park.
He's got a great technique.
He has a good technique, but 7-3 is three short of what I would like.
Matthew Robram ignited the Crows as they edged in front of St Kilda after half-time. Adelaide by 15 points. Recruits Gary Durkee and veteran Mickey Martin helped the Kangaroos come from behind in the last term to beat Richmond by 10 points. And with skipper Shane Crawford in everything and Angelo Lekas notching 34 possessions, Hawthorn kicked away after the last break against the Dockers.
Hawthorn, S. Crawford, one vote. Hawthorn, A. Lekas, two votes. Hawthorn, P. Salmon, three votes. Brisbane Lions versus Port Adelaide. Port Adelaide, B. Lyle, one vote.
Ronald tonight, I have.
Port Adelaide too lost for the first time. Geelong made it four in a row, that man hopping again. Young and Thompson guided St Kilda to an impressive 8-point win over the Bulldogs at Waverley. While the Wooden Spooners of 1998, Brisbane, kicked 11 second-half goals to two against Adelaide, the premiers of 1998. McRae and Ashcroft in the thick of things.
Yeah, I mean, Marcus was terrific, obviously, today, but Craig McRae and Nigel and Jason Akamas, they all got a lot of the ball, and I guess the four of them are our best runners. So if those four players are getting the ball, we're getting a bit of carry.
Brett Ratton was Carlton's outstanding player against Fremantle, while 14 Tigers joined in a goal feast against Collingwood. It would be the Magpies' 10th straight loss, their worst run ever.
Round four, Melbourne versus Hawthorn. Melbourne, P. Walsh, one vote. Hawthorn, S. Crawford, two votes. Melbourne, A. Leoncelli, three votes. Carlton versus Fremantle. Carlton, B. Ratton, one vote. Hawthorn versus West Coast Eagles. West Coast, D. Wirrapunda, one vote. West Coast, S. Cummings, two votes. West Coast, G. McKenna, three votes. Melbourne versus Port Adelaide. Melbourne.
Surprise at the top with three best on ground.
The West Coast captain, who played his 250th game this year, Shane Crawford, has been busy early. Craig Bradley at 35 years of age, almost 36. Glenn Kilpatrick, David Pittman, who's...
Shane Crawford starring as the Hawks won yet another thriller at Shell Stadium by 2 points. Matty Richard.
Geelong, Jay Mooney, 1 vote. Geelong, P. Riccardi, 2 votes. Hawthorn, S. Crawford, 3 votes. Richmond versus Essendon. Essendon, D. Wallace, 1 vote.
Bo's probably had a little bit of pressure on himself tonight. You know, he hasn't had the opportunities over the last few weeks because Windy's really sort of taken control of that area. So he had his opportunity tonight and I thought he handled himself very well.
Melbourne showed some of the spark of 98 with a strong victory over Essendon. Farmer with 6 for the Demons, overshadowed by Lloyd's 7 for the Losers. Lappin and McRae stood out in Brisbane's 34-point win over Collingwood, while Schwass was devastating for Sydney as the Swans' improvement continued with a 28-point win over the Hawks. Geelong, on the other hand, were on the slide.
Sydney versus Hawthorn. Sydney, S. Maxfield, 1 vote. Hawthorn, S. Crawford, 2 votes. Sydney, W. Swass, 3 votes. Fremantle versus Geelong. Fremantle, J. Sinclair.
They're too hard to feel the cold. Melbourne, those left shivering as they were overrun by the Bulldogs. A depleted Carlton struggled all night against Port Adelaide at Football Park. Treadway with 3 goals, the Power's best. The King was back on his throne. 7 goals to Wayne Carey.
Well, that speaks volumes about him that he can have 3-4 weeks off, come back and kick 7. It's a privilege to play with him.
And 7 goals to Scotty...
Kangaroos. Kangaroos, A. Simpson, 1 vote. Kangaroos, W. Carey, 2 votes. Kangaroos, B. Harvey, 3 votes. West Coast versus Adelaide. Hawthorn. Essendon, J. Blumfield, 1 vote. Essendon, G. Moorcroft, 2 votes. Essendon, B. Young, 3 votes. Fremantle versus Kangaroos. Kangaroos.
For the Tigers, but his 18 marks made it a memorable performance. His lone hand would not be enough as Hawthorn, with Paul Salmon in control, won by a goal. Torrential rain.
Richmond versus Hawthorn. Hawthorn, J. Smith, 1 vote. Richmond, M. Richardson, 2 votes. Hawthorn, P. Salmon, 3 votes. Brisbane Lions versus Western Bulldogs. Western Bulldogs, S. Wine.
Voted by Sydney. Mobile big man Adam Goods underlining his claim to be the recruit of the year.
Yeah, he did an excellent job today. He's a terrific kid already, but he's going to be a real superstar, that kid, I think, of the game.
In a low-scoring slog at Football Park, Port Adelaide's 4 goals was enough to keep Richmond out of the points. The Tigers had kicked 1 goal to three-quarter time. In game number 200 for Bulldog star Chris Grant, the points would be halved as his team drew with Hawthorn. Crawford, a standout for the Hawks with 30 possessions.
His tackle at the end was terrific with him. I mean, he's just a great competitor and, you know, I mean, he's the captain, that's why he's the captain. I mean, he leads from the front and he's played on a good player today and beat him.
Adelaide slump.
Kangaroos versus West Port Adelaide versus Fremantle versus Western Bulldogs versus Hawthorn. Hawthorn, T. Crowd, 1 vote. Hawthorn, S. Crawford, 2 votes. Western Bulldogs, C. Grant, 3 votes. Collingwood versus Melbourne. Melbourne, P. Walsh, 1 vote.
Robert Harvey and a 63-point second quarter lead were not enough as St Kilda suffered its most demoralising defeat at the hands of Hawthorn. Across...
St Kilda, R. Harvey, 1 vote. Hawthorn, A. Lekas, 2 votes. Hawthorn, N. Holland, 3 votes. Western Bulldogs versus Fremantle. Western Bulldogs, S.
With Harvey a last-minute withdrawal, St Kilda suffered yet another shocking second-half fade-out. This time, Collingwood, with Nathan Buckley and Mal Michael leading the way, sauntered home by 21 points. Port Adelaide led all night against Hawthorn, a 20-point win in a low-scoring game with Burgoyne the star. After five first-quarter...
Port Adelaide, F. Francis, one vote. Port Adelaide, W. Treadray, two votes. Port Adelaide, D. Mead, three votes. Kangaroos versus Carlton. Kangaroos, F. Carlton, C. Bradley, one vote. Carlton, A. Koutafidis, two votes. Carlton, A. Mackay, three votes. Collingwood versus Port Adelaide. Port Adelaide, N. Stevens, one vote.
Solid defenders in Silvani and Koutafidis, and the forward line domination of Pearce and Camporeale again pushed Carlton forward as a September threat. Despite being 20 points up at the last change, Collingwood let the match against Geelong just slip away. The Cats ended their horrific nine-game losing streak with Arnott, Snell and Riccardi the major reasons. A 7-0 final term gave Sydney an effortless win against Melbourne. Stevens with 19 marks, putting in a huge solo effort for the Swans. Another body blow for the Saints as they were beaten by lowly Fremantle in Perth. Fletcher the best for the Dockers. Field umpire Peter Carey getting a special mention for the most talked about mark of the season. It would be a single quarter that decided the match at the Gabba. The Lions kicking 9-0 in the third to end the Hawthorn threat. Jason Ackermanis the star. In one of the upsets of the season...
versus Hawthorn. Brisbane, M. Voss, one vote. Brisbane, M. Clark, two votes. Brisbane, J. Ackermanis, three votes. Western Bulldogs...
mark of the final quarter. They'd win by 2 points. With 7 first-half goals and 9 for the match, Wayne Carey stamped his authority on the Kangaroos' commanding 55-point win over Geelong in Sydney. This was the king at his most regal.
Yeah, Wayne's been under a bit of pressure from a few areas, and he answered his critics in the best way possible, kicking 9 goals. And, you know, we thought he was terrific tonight, and his leadership goes without saying. It was of the highest quality.
Blustery winds ruined the spectacle when Port Adelaide came home with the gale to upset Sydney at Football Park. Stevens, Lade and Mead were star performers for the Power. Carlton's finals prospects were put under scrutiny by Essendon. The Bombers won by 76 points in front of 66,000 at the MCG. In an even performance, Mercury shone. Another Nathan Buckley gem. This time the Collingwood captain had the ball on a string as he mesmerised Hawthorn. It was Collingwood's third win for the season.
Today, I reckon, was nearly the all-round captain's game, and some of those courageous marks in that last bit, in the last 10 minutes, in his direction, I thought, yeah, you wouldn't get many better than a captain game like that.
Game number 200 for Eagles.
Carlton versus Ed. Hawthorn versus Collingwood. Collingwood, G. Brown, one vote. Collingwood, T. Lane, two votes. Collingwood, N. Buckley, three votes.
Port Adelaide, with Burgoyne and Lade leading the way, recorded a club best fifth straight win. The 7-point victory over Fremantle at the Wacker pushed them into sixth place on the ladder. While Shane Crawford stood out with 40-plus possessions for Hawthorn, his side was never really in the match against Adelaide. The Crows by 49 points. In the worst defeat...
Brisbane Lions versus... Collingwood versus Carlton. Collingwood. Adelaide, N. Smart, one vote. Hawthorn, S. Crawford, two votes. Adelaide, K. Costa, three votes.
Games for the year. Malcolm Blight conjured up some more magic when he placed pint-sized Trent Ormond Allen against St Kilda's Spider Everett. It was merely a sideshow as the Crows, with Burton marking sensationally, won by 33 points. Rain and Essendon spoiled Sydney's party. In the Swans' 200th home game, the Bombers led all night and won by 14 points. After 3 straight losses, the West Coast bounced back and for the 9th time in a row proved too strong for Collingwood. Goal-kicking leader Scott Cummings helped himself to 7 in a 36-point win. Michael Voss was back to his Brownlow form of 1996 as he led Brisbane to an imposing 52-point win over Port Adelaide. For the second time this season, Carlton won a heartstopper against the Bulldogs. 2 points in round 3 and 5 points in round 18 provided the Blues with a surge from 9th to 6th place on the ladder. Ruckman Matty Allen superb.
Last time I thought Wynn had the better of Matt, but I think this time the young fella probably did the job as we would have wanted him to do.
41 touches strengthened his hold as the biggest ball winner in the AFL this season.
We tried 3 or 4 different things to try and counter him, and but to his credit, you know, he's put in a pretty good game today.
Kangaroos versus Richmond. Kangaroos, B. Pickett, 1 vote. Richmond, M. Knights, 2 votes. Kangaroos, C. McKernan, 3 votes. Sydney versus Essendon. Sydney, A. Dunkley, 1 vote. Essendon, S. Wellman, 2 votes. Sydney, W. Swass, 3 votes. West Coast Eagles versus Collingwood. Collingwood, N. Buckley, 1 vote. West Coast, S. Cummings, 2 votes. West Coast, Peter Matera, 3 votes. Carlton versus Western Bulldogs. Carlton, F. Brown, 1 vote. Western Bulldogs, L. Darcy, 2 votes. Carlton, M. Allen, 3 votes. Hawthorn versus Fremantle. Hawthorn, N. Holland, 1 vote. Hawthorn, T. Woods, 2 votes. Hawthorn, S. Crawford, 3 votes.
A 16-goal second half against its jacket-waving rivals of the 90s ensured Essendon would maintain top spot on the ladder. Peter Riccardi sparkled as Geelong revived its finals hopes and put a question mark over Port Adelaide at Shell Stadium. Captain Blood Jack Dyer and his old sidekick Lou Richards welcomed nearly 48,000 to the MCG as the Tigers met the Magpies. The game would be one-sided, with Gavin Brown helping Collingwood to its 4th win of the season. Sydney were the visitors at the SCG, but struggled against the Kangaroos. In game number 200, Anthony Stevens was everywhere. Carey kicked 4, while Mick Martin held Plugger to a lone goal.
Yeah, I thought Michael Martin was outstanding tonight. I thought he was our best player, and he did a terrific job, and you know, I couldn't rate his performance highly enough.
Carlton was moving back into contention. Matthew Allen fighting off the flu in a best-on-ground performance over a disappointing Fremantle. For the second week in a row, Brisbane won at Football Park. Chris Scott, Marcus Ashcroft and Michael Voss the best in a 39-point win over Adelaide. As Melbourne struggled off the field, its players were no match on the field for Hawthorn. A 68-point win to the Hawks, engineered by Lord with 6 goals and Crawford 3. Brownlow medalists Robert Harvey and Tony Liberatore stole the show in a slog at Optus Oval.
Fremantle versus Carlton. Hawthorn versus Melbourne. Hawthorn, D. Hartford, 1 vote. Hawthorn, A. Lord, 2 votes. Hawthorn, S. Crawford, 3 votes.
3 rounds to go, 3 votes, lots of votes to be counted, and I can't remember a better leaders board. Shane Crawford is back in front. He hit the front in round 4 earlier tonight, and he is leading the 1999 Brownlow medal, but he's got some great players sitting right on his hammer, and when we return, we'll get down to the real business end of this year's Brownlow medal.
More than 56,000 braved the bitter cold to see Essendon continue its brilliant form. Although depleted, the Bombers' comfortable winners over a Collingwood side led brilliantly by Nathan Buckley. A month short of his 34th birthday, Nicky Winmar moved like a youngster, kicking 4 goals in the Bulldogs' 36-point win over Richmond. After 7 seasons, St Kilda farewelled Waverley. Not the way they would have liked. They watched Peter Bell and Wayne Carey in brilliant form. For the second week in a row, Melbourne kicked 1 goal until half-time. Port Adelaide, with Lade outstanding, did the rest. The thriller of the round saw Hawthorn severely dent the Eagles' finals aspirations. Skipper Shane Crawford putting in a match-winning performance at the Wacker. There has never been a first half like it. 131 points on the board at half-time, and Brisbane could afford to coast home against Fremantle at the Gabba. Lawrence and Lepich standouts. An eight-goal first quarter by Geelong was just enough foundation to win the game against Carlton. The Blues' Allen and Katz Riccardi producing eye-catching performances. It was Tony Lockett.
Brisbane versus Fremantle. Brisbane, M. Voss, one vote. Brisbane, J. Lepich, two votes. Brisbane, J. Malloy, three votes. Sydney versus Adelaide. Sydney, W. Swass, one vote. Sydney, T. Lockett, two votes. Sydney, P. Kelly, three votes. Collingwood versus Essendon. Essendon, D. Rioli, one vote. Collingwood, N. Buckley, two votes. Essendon, D. Fletcher, three votes. Geelong versus Carlton. Geelong, B. Scholl, one vote. Geelong, B. Graham, two votes. Carlton, M. Allen, three votes. West Coast Eagles versus Hawthorn. Hawthorn, N. Thompson, one vote. West Coast, B. Cousins, two votes. Hawthorn, S. Crawford, three votes.
Essendon was guaranteed of top spot on the ladder after demolishing Richmond with a nine-goal second quarter. The ball handling of Mark McCurry and six goals from Lloyd said it all. St Kilda's dismal second half of the season continued. This time it was Carlton, led by the tireless veteran Craig Bradley, who made Tim Watson's boys look tired and second-rate. In game number 200 for Alistair Lynch, it would be a rookie, Tim Notting, with six goals, who helped Brisbane to an effortless win over Melbourne. Michael Voss outstanding. For the second week in a row, Hawthorn won by 2 points, this time Geelong. Shane Crawford with 28 possessions and three goals, sealing many media awards along the way.
We're talking about a bloke who's going to take himself, elevate himself into one of the great player categories in, you know, in this club's history, I reckon. You know, I mean, with the leadership he's showing and just his ability to play in a number of roles, his ability to do desperate things at desperate times. You know, like he's just, you know, I mean, that's why we respect him so much.
The Swans ensured they'd be playing finals football, and Tony Lockett, with five against Fremantle, made sure he'd be part of it. Darren Creswell was the star. In the showdown at Football Park, Port Adelaide fine-tuned their finals campaign by defeating the reigning premiers with a workmanlike performance. Josh Franku and Gavin Wanganeen leading the charge. Collingwood led into the final quarter of its match against the Kangaroos. Veteran Mick Martin again terrific for the Kangaroos in a 13-point win. And Chris Grant gave a timely reminder of his great skills as the Bulldogs held off the West Coast to win a thriller at Optus Oval.
Round 21, Melbourne versus Brisbane Lions. Brisbane, C. Keating, one vote. Brisbane, A. Huskis, two votes. Brisbane, S. Hart, three votes. Port Adelaide versus Adelaide. Port Adelaide, G. Wanganeen, one vote. Port Adelaide, J. Franco, two votes. Port Adelaide, B. Lade, three votes. Kangaroos versus Collingwood. Kangaroos, M. Martin, one vote. Collingwood, M. Michael, two votes. Kangaroos, A. Simpson, three votes. Western Bulldogs versus West Coast. Western Bulldogs, S. Garlick, one vote. West Coast, S. Cummings, two votes. West Coast, B. Cousins, three votes. Fremantle versus Sydney. Sydney, D. Lewis, one vote. Sydney, D. Creswell, two votes. Fremantle, A. Fletcher, three votes. Carlton versus St Kilda. Carlton, K. Massey, one vote. Carlton, F. Brown, two votes. Carlton, C. Bradley, three votes. Essendon versus Richmond. Essendon, J. Blumfield, 1 vote. Essendon, M. Lloyd, 2 votes. Essendon, M. McCurry, 3 votes. Hawthorn versus Geelong. Geelong, P. Riccardi, 1 vote. Hawthorn, T. Crowd, 2 votes. Hawthorn, S. Crawford, 3 votes.
There is still one round to go in the 1999 Brownlow medal. And Wayne, to complete formalities, would you please read out the votes for round number 22?
Round 22, Collingwood v Brisbane Lions. Brisbane, C. Keating, 1 vote. Brisbane, N. Lappin, 2 votes. Brisbane, S. Lawrence, 3 votes. Western Bulldogs versus Port Adelaide. Western Bulldogs, B. Montgomery, 1 vote. Western Bulldogs, S. West, 2 votes. Western Bulldogs, L. Darcy, 3 votes. West Coast Eagles versus St. Kilda. St. Kilda, D. Wakelin, 1 vote. St. Kilda, S. Zilla, 2 votes. St. Kilda, A. Thompson, 3 votes. Adelaide versus Kangaroos. Kangaroos, P. Bell, 1 vote. Kangaroos, D. King, 2 votes. Kangaroos, B. Pickett, 3 votes. Geelong versus Fremantle. Geelong, G. Kilpatrick, 1 vote. Fremantle, A. Fletcher, 2 votes. Geelong, C. Steinfort, 3 votes. Hawthorn versus Sydney. Hawthorn, J. Smith, 1 vote. Hawthorn, N. Holland, 2 votes. Hawthorn, N. Thompson, 3 votes. Richmond versus Carlton. Richmond, B. Ottens, 1 vote. Richmond, M. Knights, 2 votes. Carlton, C. Bradley, 3 votes. Essendon versus Melbourne. Melbourne, S. Phoebe, 1 vote. Essendon, D. Rioli, 2 votes. Essendon, M. Long, 3 votes. Ladies and gentlemen, I declare Shane Crawford the winner of the 1999 Brownlow Medal.
Ladies and gentlemen, to present the 1999 Brownlow Medal to Shane Crawford, the man who's won the last two Brownlow Medals, Robert Harvey from St Kilda. Ladies and gentlemen, Robert Harvey. Shane, it's my pleasure now to reintroduce Ron Evans, the chairman of the Australian Football League, who will propose the toast to Shane Crawford, the 1999 winner. Ron.
Shane, the Australian Football League and all football followers around Australia congratulate you on winning the 1999 Brownlow Medal. When we consider the list of captains of the Hawthorn Football Club, which includes such champions as Jason Dunstall, Chris Langford, Gary Ayres, Michael Tuck, Lee Matthews, Don Scott, David Parkin, Shane Crawford has joined a very elite group when he was named as captain of the Hawthorn team this year. Shane, you've set an outstanding example for your club with your skill, your athleticism and your leadership. Congratulations, you're our worthy winner. Ladies and gentlemen, could I ask you to be upstanding and join me in proposing the toast to the 1999 Brownlow medalist? Shane Crawford.
Shane Crawford!
Thank you. Thank you to Ron Evans and also to Robert Harvey for making the presentation. Gee, that's not a very big bit of paper you've got there, Shane. The pressure of favouritism. We haven't had a hotter favourite, I don't think, since Jim Steins in 1991. Did you feel that at all in the last week or two?
Oh, very much so. It's amazing. Once you become a favourite for the Brownlow, the expectations are so high, and I actually couldn't wait for the night to be over because I wanted to find out who was going to win, and I was hoping that it was going to be me, but it's just, you know, it's amazing to be a Brownlow medalist up there, not only with the players that are still playing like Robert Harvey, but just the champions of the past, and I can't believe it. I really can't.
Who did you think were your main dangers when you arrived tonight? The people that were up the top, people like Mark McCurry and Nathan Buckley and Matthew Allen?
Yeah, very much so. They all had great years, and they're all in winning sides except for Nathan, but he seems to poll very well. No, I didn't mean anything like that, but I'm sure if he was in a side that won, you know, over 10 games, he no doubt would, you know, probably be standing up here tonight. But I'm just glad the night's finished and
You're nearly there.
Relieved. Yeah.
Your mum, who must have played such a huge role in your development. Both you and your brother have played AFL football. You've both been sent to Assumption College. I know there's another boy in the family as well, but Diane's with us from Finlay right now, Shane. She's able to talk to you. She's there she is, in the New South Wales country town of Finlay. So Mum's made a lot of sacrifices. It must have been pretty tough for Mum as a single mum bringing you and your brothers up. You got a word or two to say to her right now?
Actually, I'm going to start crying. Football is hard. Where'd you cry?
You can cry as much as you like. Diane, how do you feel about Shane and his achievements tonight?
I think it's absolutely wonderful, and I'm so proud.
Have you been as nervous as your son tonight?
Beg your pardon?
Have you been as nervous as your son tonight?
Oh, I've been shopping. I can tell you, I've been walking around.
You better say hello, Shane.
Just talking to people, trying to keep my mind off things.
G'day, Mum. How are you going?
Hi, Shane. Congratulations. I wish I was there. But Olivia will give you a kiss for me.
It's quite funny because I was asked if Mum wanted to come, and I would have loved her to be here, especially, now that I've won, but she would have stressed me right out. And if I hadn't have won, God knows what she would have done, I'm trying not to say too much because I think I'm going to start crying every time I look at her, so I'm just very proud to have a mother like she's been. She's been absolutely tremendous, and that's it from me about my mum.
Diane, I think Shane's just gone like that to you, but any last words from Finlay, and how will you celebrate tonight?
Shane, you just want to thank all the people here in Finlay. They're all here at the club supporting.
I'm sure you do. Diane, thank you very much for being a part of the night. Your dear mum there in Finlay. Shane, are there people you want to thank?
Yep, sure. Well, firstly, the umpires, thanks very much.
You've got one of them almost as your coach next year too, haven't you, Swobby?
Yeah, no, we've done very well there. We've got Peter Swob coaching us, who will be absolutely tremendous. So thank you very much to the umpires. To Ken Judge, I wish you all the very best with the West Coast Eagles. to Bowden Babichik, who's our fitness advisor. He's like a personal trainer to everyone, and I have no doubt I wouldn't be up here tonight without all of his help. To all the Hawthorn supporters, all the people from Finlay, everyone that's sent me faxes, called me on the phone, thank you very much for your support. It's very much appreciated. I do appreciate it very much, and I'm the happiest person in the world, even though I can't seem to smile at the moment. I don't know what my body's doing to myself. I'm shaking. I'm very nervous, but I'm only, 5'8", but I feel about 6', and I'm certainly on top of the world at the moment. To my mum, I won't say too much, but, she's very courageous in what she's done for me, and she's brought us up by herself. We were young kids, and I love her very much. To Olivia Anderson, you've been tremendous to me, and I thank you very much for that. And I better thank all my teammates here tonight, Ben Dixon, Angelo Lickus, Paul Salmon, Richard Taylor, Mark Graham. Thanks very much. They kept telling me I was going to win all night, and I had a lot of doubt. And they just kept telling me, no, you'll be right. Keep drinking. Just enjoy the night. And I had a lot of doubt, especially when Mark McCurry went past me, and I'm thinking maybe the umpires don't like me, but I'm very appreciative of your support. Thanks very much, guys. And just to finish off with the people who have helped me throughout the year, sponsorship-wise, people from Audi, Jason Richardson from Oakley, and who else? The people from Puma and also Samsung. Thanks very much for helping not only the club but also myself, hopefully pushing forward in my career. So thank you very much. And I'm going to have a great night tonight, so thanks for having me.
Shane, terrific. Just a couple of final ones. And by the way, you're not 5'8", because I'm 6'2". You must be at least 6'3". The captaincy, Ron Evans, the chairman, mentioned that great line, and I saw Chris Langford a moment ago go up and congratulate you, and Lee Matthews is here tonight, and Jason Dunstall and all the other great Hawthorn captains. What did that do for you, being named captain of the club?
Oh, it was a tremendous honour. Something I suppose you only dream about as a kid, not only playing AFL football, but to be a captain of the club. And I really thought that over the last 2 years I've grown as a player, and I thought I was ready to take on the responsibility of being the leader. I've loved it. It's a great club to be in charge of. The guys who I play with, they're just so helpful. They just want to really improve, and I have no doubt over the next few years we can certainly improve as a side. So it's been a fantastic position for me to be in. I thank all the people from Hawthorn who believed in me, and I'm just very grateful for that. And just quickly, I'd like to thank all the people in Finlay once again. I know it's only a little country town, but they'll all be celebrating very hard as they do every night, but I'd like to thank them very much, and that's all I've got to say. Thanks.
Well, just finally, the last number nine to win the Brownlow was Dipper. I'm sure Dipper would hate me mentioning that tonight. He's here, he's so shy. He also has trouble with Dragosevich too, Wayne, but he finally got it out at the end of the night, just like you. So, same number.
Yeah, it's amazing because my birthday is actually on the 9th of the 9th, and this year it's 99, so it's just seems to be happening around the number 9. And Cole Austin, actually, who played with Hawthorn, won the Brownlow with number 9 50 years ago from tonight. So a lady actually came up and said that tonight. So she said, "You're going to win because this is what's happened." So I thought, oh, well, great. It's going to
happen. There you go. Well, that's enough of 9. This is on 7, as you well know. Shane, congratulations.
Thanks, Bruce.
A wonderful achievement. Could we have had a better Brownlow medalist in this year? The last Brownlow medalist of the 20th century, the captain of the Hawthorn Footy Club, Shane Crawford. Enjoy the rest of the night, Shane, and we'll be back with more in just a moment.
with 28, one of the shortest prize favourites in the history of the Brownlow medal, and certainly in the 90s along with Jim Stein. 1999 Brownlow medal, and what a worthy winner. I can tell you that in the teams that Brisbane got the most votes, Essendon the second most, and the Western Bulldogs the third, as we check the overall leaderboard tonight, and we see that Shane Crawford with 28 has won by a clear margin in the end, but it was such an exciting count. Mark McCurry on 22, six behind, and then Nathan Buckley equal third along with Matthew Allen.